we realized early on, this is back 10 years ago, actually, when we were first working the COTS program, that cost plus contracting, it really misaligns business incentives between the government and the providers. We joke that, you know, the more stupid the government is, the more money the contractor makes. That's kind of the common view, and it's pretty accurate, because what happens is that cost plus, the contractor, he's going to have his cost covered regardless. And so if the government changes its mind or has bad requirements to going in, they get to just, you know, get paid, you know, to do the job 2, 3, 4 times. And we did a little bit of research, okay, where did cost plus contracting come from? And our understanding is that actually it came up during World War II, when urgency was the most critical factor in getting a product in place. And so the cost efficiency, that wasn't important. That was down, way down the priority list, is that we need to get somebody working on this. And when you're fighting a war, that makes sense. Urgency matters, okay? So getting someone to work on a project, even if you aren't quite sure what it's going to be, you're not quite sure about the requirements, but get somebody working on it, so as soon as we understand the requirements, you know, we can have a product, you know, as quickly as possible. That makes perfect sense in that type of environment. And our understanding is that over time, both the government and industry got kind of hooked on this bad practice, because firm fixed price, again, there's lots of models that show that gives you much better alignment of business goals. Firm fixed price, the government gets what it asks for, but has to stick to what it asks for. The business actually can make more than just a fee with regard to what they're doing, so there's more incentive to them. But the government can't be changing what it's doing, okay? But they have to then deliver, okay? So it provides better incentives for the government to be clear about what we want and stick to it, not, you know, wander around, and for the industry to produce and produce well, okay? So it gives you alignment of business goals. And so it looks like, to us, it was just, you know, something was born out of urgency of war that kind of became common practice and probably used too much. And again, I'm sure there are circumstances where, again, cost plus is the best approach, particularly if you aren't quite sure what the requirements are for a number of reasons, and so you're going to have to iterate around. But it looks like the more we look into it, that should be an exception to what, you know, NASA does, not the standard approach, and that the standard approach really should be much more firm fixed price, you know, FAR Type 12, you know, commercial purchases, again, where you have an alignment of business goals so that the government wins and the contractor wins. That's what you're looking for. Not that, okay, you know, if the government is really, you know, ill-prepared, that the contractor cleans up. That is a situation you want to avoid if you want to incentivize cost effectiveness. And again, it's not a mystery. It's just, okay, that I think a bad practice that kind of got out of hand.